Hey everyone, Chell here with Prismatic Powders, and today we're going to perform a couple of experiments because we want to demonstrate a couple of different factors that affect the look of metallic powders. Voltage and nozzle choice. And the results may surprise you. Depending on your setup, especially if it's a professional system like a Nordson or a Gema, you've got a plethora of nozzle options and likely voltage control up to 100 kilovolts.
What? A plethora?
So knowing what nozzle and voltage to use for your project can really level up your finish and assist you in a variety of applications. The size, shape, and complexity of your parts will influence your decision on nozzle choice, and the shape and complexity of your parts should also influence your voltage selection. And when it comes to metallics, you should definitely be considering these factors as well, and we're going to show you why. For this demonstration, we're focusing on three common nozzle types and showing you exactly how they perform with a non-bonded metallic powder, and then we'll focus on voltage. The first nozzle is the flat, slot, or fan nozzle. This one compresses the powder into a narrow spray pattern, and it's perfect for large flat surfaces, but it will condense the distribution of metallic flakes. Next is the castle. The castle is so named because it looks like a little castle tower. You see that? At least that is my version of the story. The notches around the edge of that center point let powder flow out in multiple directions, and this is great. You're still having concentration in the center, but they give you nice, balanced, concentrated flow. Lastly is the conical nozzle, and this is a whole different beast. Instead of condensing, it disperses powder around a deflector, and it's actually two parts. The pattern adjuster and the deflector, and both are customizable. So if you want a wider pattern, slide the adjuster back. If you need a narrow pattern, slide it forward. Simple, versatile. All right, let's go to work. Now the difference in nozzle selection did not affect this color much at all. We sprayed everything with the same settings at 50 kilovolts. The flat and conical nozzles transferred the most metallic, but really you're kind of splitting hairs to detect the differences between them all. Now let's take a look at how voltage affects a different color that has similar metallic content. For this experiment, we used the two nozzles that yielded the most metallic transfer from the previous test, the flat and the conical. The first two parts were sprayed at 50 kilovolts, and again, you can see that there's not much difference between them. So what happens when we reduce the voltage down to 35 kilovolts? Now there's a dramatic difference that takes place as the voltage drops. There's far less metallic content being transferred. Those heavier metallic flakes needed that extra voltage to effectively transfer to the parts. But let's take a little closer look. Despite having identical voltage, there's far more metallic content from the conical nozzle. This is likely because the conical nozzle helped disperse the metallic flake more evenly into a less dense cloud, which allowed it to settle onto the part a little bit easier. So what's the takeaway from this experiment? What we're seeing is that the look of a non-bonded metallic can be dramatically affected by both nozzle choice and voltage, but most critically is voltage. So if you happen to be spraying one of these types of powders and you're not getting the look you want, you may need to take a look at your voltage and make an adjustment, possibly a nozzle change. All right, that is it for this one. Hopefully this helps you and gives you something to think about. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Do that thing if you find this type of content helpful. That's what this channel is all about. We'll see you next time.